Okay, so we're going to be going over 1 to 108, sprint number 30. This is a number theory problem that involves a theorem called LTE, or lifting the exponent. And this theorem describes the number of occurrences of a certain prime factor P in the difference of two powers, x to the n and y to the n. And so we'll go over the problem statement first. Let n be the least positive integer such that 730 to the 2 to the n factorial does not leave a remainder of 1 when divided by 3 to the n. And basically what this means is we want 3 to the n does not divide 730 to the 2n factorial minus 1. Note that since 3 to the n only contains factors of 3, we only need to consider factors of 3 on the right side. And this is where we'll use the notation vp. Basically, the function vp describes the number of occurrences of a prime factor p in the prime factorization of a number n. So in other words, suppose vp of k, or vp of n, equals k. What this means is that k is the number of occurrences of p in the prime factorization of n. Or in other words, p to the k divides n, but p to the k plus 1 does not divide n. So for example, v5 of 125 would be 3. V5 of 250 would also be 3. And v7 of 98 would be 2. And so now we'll use this notation to express what we want here. Since 3 is the prime factor of concern, we're going to be using p equals 3. So we're going to denote this function v3. Since we want 3 to the n to not divide the right-hand side, we want v3 of 3 to the n to be greater than v3 of 730 to the 2n factorial. The left-hand side just equals n. And for the right-hand side, we're about to see how LTE comes in. LTE describes vp of the difference of two powers. There's actually two conditions to this theorem. This only applies under the conditions that p is odd, so any prime factor that's not 2, and x minus y has to be divisible by p. So for example, vp will apply for p equals 3, and x and y equals 7 and 4, and for any n. So we have the conditions that p must be prime, and x minus y has to be divisible by p. So we're considering v3, so this holds since 3 is odd. And also we can express 730 to the 2n factorial minus 1 as 730 to the 2n factorial minus 1 to the 2n factorial. And now we can see how LTE comes in, because we just substitute x equals 730, y equals 1, and the exponent n equals 2n factorial. And so now substituting, we want our equation now becomes n equals v3 of 730 minus 1 plus v3 of 2n factorial. And 730 minus 1 equals 729, and which equals 3 to the 6th power. So v3 of 729 is obviously 6. Now this equation just equals n is greater than 6 plus v3 of 2n factorial. And we're also going to rearrange this to the form n minus v3 n factorial is greater than 6. Since we want this to be greater than 6, but the right side is always an integer, another way to write this, n minus v3 of 2 n factorial is at least 7. And this form will be more relevant to how we're going to find the minimum value of n. So now we have our equation here, and this is much easier to solve after using our lifting the exponent lemma. So I'll erase this from our space. And note that we want the number of prime factors 3 into n factorial. And note that v3 of 2n factorial can be written as floor of 2n over 3 plus floor of 2n. And this is the infinite sum, where the numerator is always 2n, and then the denominator is all powers of 3. However, note that we can write n as a similar infinite sum, we can write n equals 2n over 3 plus 2n over 9 plus 27 plus etc. And this sum is true just by infinite geometric sums. However, note that in this form, n minus v3 of 2n factorial, we can also subtract these two because this term and this term align. Floor of 2n over 9 and 2n over 9 also align, and etc. So all these terms in both of the infinite sums will align, which makes it easier to subtract. Now using these two equations and subtracting, we get n minus v3 of 2n equals, we now have the fractional part of 2n over 3 plus fractional part of 2n over 9 plus fractional part of 2n over 27 plus 81. Okay. So now we want this sum to be at least 7. And note by definition of a fractional part, each of these individual terms have to be less than 1. So each of these terms have to be at least 0 and less than 1. And note that when we keep going, these denominators will keep getting bigger. And at some point, the denominator will get so huge that will be so much bigger than 2n that this fractional part doesn't matter that much, it doesn't really greatly affect the sum. We're considering the parts or the terms where that are still relevant to the sum. So what this means is that we want to consider that the ones with denominators that are still around 2n. So we can just consider and is greater than 3 to the k for some k, but is less than 3 to the k plus 1, we can simply consider a majority of the terms or a majority of the sum just by looking at the first k terms. For example, this will go all the way up to the floor of 2n over 3 to the k. Earlier, we said that fractional terms will, by definition, are strictly less than 1. But we want as many terms as possible to be as close to 1 as possible. And what this means is that we want 2n to be negative 1 mod the denominator. Basically, what this means is that if 2n over 3 fractional has to be as close as possible to 1, we want 2n to be 1 less than a multiple of 3, because starting on a multiple of 3, this will just be an integer, and it will have no fractional part, but simply by decrementing by 1, the fractional part will be as close to 1 as possible. And we have this expression to maximize the first term. And to maximize the second term, we'll have something like 2n equals negative 1. We'll have 2n equals negative 1, negative 1, etc. And I'll erase this from our space. But the general pattern here is 2n will be negative 1 mod power of 3. So the best choice of action here is to select 2n to the k minus 1 for some k. And this k is actually the same as the one we defined earlier. After k, 2 to the n, or 2n will be less than 3 to the k plus 1. And after that, and since 2n is less than 3 to the k plus 1, this will no longer apply. For example, say if we choose k equals 3, so 2n over, so we want to go up to k equals 3, then we can choose something like n equals 13, for example, because 2n will be 26. And then choosing 26 will make the third fractional term 26 over 27, which is really close to 1. But after this, we'll get 26/81. And this reasoning will not apply anymore because it's actually not high enough to reach negative 1 mod a higher power of 3. We wanted n minus v3 of 27. And so the best thing to do here, since we want to make each of the terms as close as possible to 1, but all the other terms will be irrelevant, we want to achieve at least 7. So this means that we want to make the first seven of these terms as close as possible to 1. In other words, we want to choose k equals 7. How this will work is by choosing k equals 7, we'll choose 2n equals 3 to the 7 minus 1. And what this does here, you can see that when we divide by 3, 3 to the 7 is divisible by 3. But by decrementing the extra 1 here, we'll actually get a fractional part of 2/3. And similarly, 3 to the 7 is divisible by 9, but by decrementing 1, we'll get a fractional part of 8/9. Here we'll get 26/27. Here we'll get 80/81. And this pattern continues of achieving fractional parts that are as close as 1 as possible until for 7 terms. And then after this, say for a fractional part of 3 to the 7, 1 over say 3 to the 8, this will not be close to 1 anymore because the fractional part, or because the denominator is just so big that the numerator doesn't really have an effect. And so we'll consider k equals 7 and 2n equals 3 to the 7 minus 1. In this case, we just get 2n equals 2186. And so we kind of have to check if this actually works, because what happens here is that, well, we have a bunch of terms that are close to 1, and we have 7 of them. So in theory, we should have something that's close to 7. We also have to determine if like the rest of the sums are enough to bring it over 7. And in fact, this is true. We can test it by simply finding v3 of 2186 factorial. So for example, we choose n equals half of 2186, which is 1093. And then we want to find v3 of 2186. It can just be done by using the expansion we described, using the floor of each of the terms. And just by adding these, this sum equals 1086. And then as you can see here, it's just what we wanted. We have n minus v3 of 1086, and this equals 7, which is greater than the 6 we originally had. And then so now we can confirm that this n works. If we were to choose a smaller n, say the 7th term here, the 7th term to fractional 2n over 3 to the 7, if we start going down, then this term will start decreasing as well. This term will start decreasing since it was already less than 3 to the 7. So if we decrease 2n further, then this term will only get smaller. These will oscillate around since 2 to the n mod the denominator is constantly changing. But note that since this term will just get further and further away from 1, and we only have 6 of the remaining terms, given 2n keeps decreasing, this sum will not be enough to be greater than 6. So we know that n has to be at least 1093. The product of these of the digits of n is just 27. And so we have the answer here, d equals 27.
Hi, everybody. This is Tim. Hope you're enjoying our videos. If so, you know what to do. Like, subscribe, turn on notifications, all that sort of thing. But what I'd really want to invite you to do is to send us an email at media@mathleague.org. Tell us which problems you'd like to see us cover next in our video series. Take care and see you in the next video.